Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. We recently had a visitor from Georgia named Jim Franklin, who's a special ed teacher, who shows us an interesting way to look at math. It's all about math manipulatives, and it is interesting. Let's see what this is all about.
Hi, my name is Jim Franklin. I'm a special education teacher from Elm Street Elementary in Rome, Georgia. I'm at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indianapolis, and the reason why I'm here, I've invented a number line that goes to 10 million by incorporating the base 10 system and other math manipulatives that help with fractions, decimals, elapsed time, weight, and money. My manipulatives are available in three different sizes, 11 inches, 24 inches, and 32 inches. They're also available for low vision and blind students. The 24 inch has braille as well as tactile dots for our low vision and braille learners. The first manipulative that we're going to do today is with my 100X math manipulative. A few features to notice before we get started. There's a line in the middle, so then that way students can tell which way to go when they round numbers. There's an arrow that tells going 50 or more this way, or 49 or less going this way. But one of the most common ways for students to determine how to round their numbers is the proximity of their fingers to the windows on the left or the right. The first math problem that we're going to do is round 588 to the nearest 100. Like all my manipulatives, you want to round by moving the slides first. 500. Each line here is worth 1. So over here would be 600. And so to answer this question, round 588 to the nearest 100. 588. Again, my finger's closer to the window on the right. It's on this side of the line, and 88 is greater than 50. So your final answer is 600. All right, the next manipulative we're going to do is my fractions 16ths. With this, students can add or subtract mixed numbers with different denominators without paper and pencil. They can compare fractions less than or greater than. But the problem we're going to do today is 5 1/2 plus 4/16. But first, what we have to do is understand that these lines should be considered as a piece of string, cut in halves, fourths, eighths, and sixteenths. So the first problem is this. Establish the whole numbers, 5, and the next number is 6. 5 1/2, and you're going to add 4/16, because 8/16 and 1/2 are equivalent fractions. You can drop straight down, then add 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Many of our students would say our final answer is 5 12/16, but as you can see, this number can be simplified to 5 3/4. This problem can be made available for low vision and blind students because braille can be applied. Thank you for watching my tech tips. Hopefully my math strategies can help your students learn their math standards. If you would, go to my website and you'll see worksheet downloads where you can see the functions of my manipulatives as well as the versatility. Also on my website, I encourage you to read my Education World article because it talks about my differentiation of instruction with my number line to 10 million. Hopefully I'll see you at an upcoming conference, and have a great day.
So there's a new way to look at math and math manipulatives. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.